Hi, I'm Lauren with Leaf and Stem Learning. Today I'm going to show you how to do long division using the tops and bottoms method so that you can teach your students who are struggling how to do division in a way that it can be quick and easier for them. Here we go. So here we have our division problem, 2,309 divided by 7. Our first step is to make a table. This is called our tops and bottoms table. On the tops, we list all the digits. We begin at 0, and we will go all the way to 9. We do not need to list the number 10 because it is not a digit. It's two digits. So we've got 0 through 9. These are the numbers that will be our quotients or on the top of the division symbol. Now we're going to list our bottoms. These are the multiples of our numbers in the chart already. If your students do not know how to divide and multiply fluently with their facts yet, you can use this little device. It's just a little set of counting dots for them to use. I made 7 counting dots because I'm dividing by 7. So I begin thinking of my multiples. Well, 0 times 7 is still 0, and 1 times 7 is 7. If your students have trouble after that, they can use their counting dots. How that works is we say 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Notice how I touched each dot while I counted. That's important to help them make sure that they don't accidentally skip a number and get off on their counting. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, and so on. Once you have your tops and bottoms chart prepared, these are the steps that you'll use to complete the algorithm. We look at the number that we are going to be dividing, but instead of thinking about division, we're going to be thinking about subtraction. Which of these numbers is the largest number that I can subtract from 2 and not get a negative value? Well, I can subtract 0, but as soon as I get to 7, our first number, 2 minus 7 would give me a negative number. So I'm not going to use 7, I'm going to use 0. So I say my top is 0, my bottom is 0. Top, bottom. Subtract, bring down. I now have a new number that I'm going to use to subtract. Which of the bottoms is the largest number that I can use to subtract from 23 and not get a negative value? I can subtract 21, but once I've used 28, it's too large. So I will use 21, 3 and 21. Tops, bottoms. Subtract, bring down. Now I have the number 20. Which of these numbers is the largest number I can subtract from 20? That's 14. 2, 14, that's our tops and bottoms. Subtract. Bring down. Now we have the number 69. Which of these numbers is the largest number I can subtract from 69? It's 63. Tops, bottoms, subtract. I now have nothing to bring down. At this point, I could either have my student add a decimal and zeros or use this number as my remainder,